When some pony offers you a free vacation, you just sign the paperwork and don't ask questions.
Okay, I get bogus free cruise offers at least 3 times a week. Don't fall for their lies. What's not a lie is how much I enjoyed this episode. Let's start with the simple fact. This episode respects its characters. That includes Spike and his generous offer to stay and handle Twilight's responsibilities.
You're as much a part of my family as any pony.
Aw, that is so sweet. And we're not getting a repeat of Princess Spike because he's very clear on the roles.
I can keep track of the friendship log, boost community morale, and answer fan mail for a few days.
So I don't mind that he's not a part of this sudden family trip, because that family trip includes Twilight's parents, who sound less creepy now that they don't have their children's voices. Twilight clearly got her organizational skills from her papa.
Oh, I just love how the numbers and letters are organized in their little boxes.
And maybe a little wild streak from Mommy Dearest.
The endless open air, the water in my mane, oh, the small confines of the barrel!
Given that these two have mostly been standing in the background and smiling, it's wonderful to see them presented as more dynamic characters. Of the group, however, Shining Armor takes it on the chin. He's had more growth over the series as we've seen his nerdy and emotional sides, but my favorite view of him was as the struggling new father. Here, the air sickness joke just makes me wonder how he became captain of the Royal Guard. The more we see him emotionally and now physically break down, the more I wonder how he has the chops for such a job. Then again, I now know why he never accompanied Celestia on her journeys. Hard to look regal when your captain of the guard is blowing chunks. But Cadence, how I have waited for her to step up to the plate. Longtime viewers know that she is not my favorite character, and her fans have asserted that she can be a great mentor to Twilight. And here's the thing, I agree with them. She's more approachable than the legendary figures like Celestia and Luna, and a bit more with it in the current generation. But she's never really been given the chance to just sit down and really talk with Twilight until now.
Well, sometimes ponies want more from a princess than you can give, and it can be hard to know where to draw the line.
I don't know about her assertion that caring for Flurryheart takes precedence over royal duties, but this world doesn't follow the trends of real-life monarchies. But here's the thing, so often in the show, it seems like she's been characterized by giving others a frustrated look as they fail. Somehow boosting Cadence up meant bringing everyone else down. Yet here, she's bringing her best self without having to tear anyone else down. This episode does more for me to appreciate Cadence than any other, and I'm glad for that. But we're not done yet. Oh no, there's Star Tracker as well. A stand-in for every well-meaning but awkward fan of the show the staff have likely encountered over the years. Yes, I'm getting a strong meta vibe here, in the same spirit as Fame and Misfortune. Yet I'm not harsh on this aptly named pony. He didn't know the whole thing was a deception. He was nervous and trying to be helpful, but you could tell he was terrified of making a mistake. He was even humble enough to wait in line and not ask for special treatment. While I felt bad for Twilight and empathized with her breakdown and frustration, I'm glad she and Star Tracker reconciled and the little guy stood up for her.
Leave the princess alone!
Your ace is with me, kid. I get the sense that the staff are both venting their own experiences, but also saying that they do want people to be happy and enjoy the fruit of their efforts. It's all about finding that balance and respecting the staff as people first and foremost. As to Iron Will, Iron Will. I've said before that I don't watch the show expecting plot twists. I know how most of these stories will go because I'm older than the intended audience and have seen this before. But when I heard that voice,
I hope you ponies feel welcome aboard because you are!
I was so excited. It's fun to see this merciless businessman, a contender to rival Flim and Flam, back in action. My last sighting of him was in the Siege of the Crystal Empire comic stories, where he sided with the resurrected King Sombra and Queen Chrysalis. So, yeah, I'm glad he's not become a fugitive traitor and whatnot. So I can't say it's a
what a twist
moment, but it is a wonderful surprise. And now I must go and watch the rest of Season 7, which got leaked online somehow. Seriously, what is it with this season? But for this episode, I had a lot of fun and gained a great appreciation for several characters. I'm hoping for more like this. I'm Silver Quilted. Thanks for watching.